Hello. So this is not how we plan to start this build. You might notice I'm on my own. That's because I was on my way down to build when Sean called me and let me know that someone who's been helping with the prep for this build has been in contact with someone with coronavirus. So they've had to quarantine themselves. Now Sean's already been in contact with him, so he's gonna carry on working. I'm not going to go until I know whether or not this person has coronavirus, which means this is gonna be very interesting. Go!
Kids invent stuff.
We challenged kids to send us their ideas for crazy new electric vehicles. And we were sent loads of awesome ideas, including a popcorn container shaped electric car, an electric dinosaur car, and even an electric vehicle with a bouncy castle on the roof. But we can only build one electric vehicle this month. So here is what we're gonna be building. Drum roll! We are going to make 11-year-old Alex's electric dog car. It is a dog-shaped electric car with a mechanical wagging tail and a whole load of awesome doggy features. So that's what we're going to be building this video. When I say we, I kind of mean me for now, but hopefully Ruth will be here very soon.
To bring to life Alex's electric dog car, we're going to need a motor to drive the vehicle along, connected to a battery to power it. Alex also wanted her car to have a mechanical tail, so we're going to create a motorized wagging mechanism that we can mount on the back of the vehicle. And we'll also build in some other fun accessories as we go.
So for 11-year-old Alex's electric dog car, we're gonna build it as a three-wheeler. We're gonna have two of these wheels on the front for steering, controlled by a little go-kart steering wheel. And then on the back, we're gonna use this third wheel, which is an electric hub motor wheel. So it's got a powerful electric motor built into the middle of the wheel here. And this wheel even has Bluetooth, so we can connect it to a tablet and we can see how fast we're going and we can control it to make the car drive along. So we've welded together the steering mechanism for Alex's electric dog car, and we've connected together the two front steering wheels with this rack and pinion steering mechanism. So this is a mechanism out of a ride-on lawnmower, and the way it works is if you turn this part here, which we're going to connect to our little steering wheel, there are some gears inside that move that allow us to turn both wheels at the same time. So we can turn left or right and steer the car along. But you might have noticed that this wheel has a puncture, so we've got to fix that before we do anything else. We should really get an automatic pump rather than the world's smallest bicycle pump. But we do have a new workshop, so there's lots of opportunity for tools. Don't show people, it's currently a mess. This is exciting. We have wheels. We have a motor! So the steering works. Time to replace our little clamp here with a steering wheel and to connect up our electric motor and to just build the rest of the car. We've got a driving seat and we've even got a seat belt so we can be lovely and safe when we're driving the dog car. So all we've got to do now is work out where we're going to mount this on the frame so we can work out where our feet need to go for the pedals, the brake and the accelerator. Seatbelt! So Alex drew her electric dog car as having this lovely curved front and roof. So we've cut out these plywood ribs, which we are going to mount onto our metal frame, like this and like this. And that's going to go along the front here. And then we've got this really bendy plywood, which we are going to screw to the front of that. And eventually, we're going to cover it in fur to make a lovely, furry, curvy dog car. So we always like the kids' inventions we build to look as close as possible to the original drawing. So we've put 11-year-old Alex's dog car drawing into some computer-aided design software, and we've sketched around it to get an outline of the car, and we've made a simple 3D model from the outline, and we're taking measurements from that model to decide on the shape of the car as we build it. So we're going to need a way to speed up and slow down our dog car. So we've taken these, which are bike brake levers, and we've got two of those, and they're going to connect on to here. And then we've made a little plate, and this is going to work as our foot brake. So the plate's going to mount on here. So we can use those two bike brake levers to control our rear brake and our front brakes. And then over here, we're going to put another foot pedal, which is going to be our accelerator, so we can control the speed of the vehicle. So to make the back of the dog car curve downwards, like on Alex's drawing, we've welded some of these bits of little rod onto the back of the frame of the vehicle. And we've got some of this flexible white water pipe that we're going to join on in hoops. And then we're going to have some others coming the other way, so we can join them together and make a lattice structure that we can have on the back of the vehicle. So we finished the pipe structure for the back of our car, and it's looking pretty strong. So I'm feeling confident that I can do a little test and see if it can actually take my weight. Who'd have thought just like a load of pipes and some cable ties would actually be strong enough to hold my weight?
Pretty quiet without Ruth, and there's no one for me to prank. We have a steering wheel! It's officially a car now.
I'm all alone, there's no one here besides me.
So our friend's got the all clear. I can build! Let's go surprise Sean.
Someone's here!
Hi!
Ruth!
I made it! I've arrived!
It's a dog car!
It's a dog car! Oh, I'm so glad to be here!
It's been really weird.
It's been the most frustrating thing.
So we haven't got much time, so we better finish building a dog car.
Let's go! Let's cut some windows. Hi!
So we can't build a dog car without it being fluffy! So we've got 15 square metres of artificial fluff.
Ah! It's all fluffy!
Are we ready for the shiny, shiny, shiny? This is so exciting. Feels like a proper car. We've got a windscreen. So much fur.
It's all fluffy, I'm gonna die.
So our electric motor came with a thumb throttle, but this is a car. We want an accelerator pedal. So we've got this DIY accelerator pedal that connects to the thumb throttle, so as you push it forwards, it makes the dog car go faster.
So Alex's invention idea has a dog tail that wags. So inside the car, we've mounted a windscreen wiper motor. Outside the car, we're gonna use these pool noodles to sculpt a tail with some fur. We're gonna attach it to the car, and it's gonna wag!
Do you want me to pick your nose?
We're not shaking hands anymore, are we? Might get coronavirus.
I'm making a very sophisticated tail out of bubble wrap. I promise, at the end it will look like a tail.
You mean not all dogs' tails are made out of bubble wrap, pool noodles and duct tape?
Oh gee, it's really high tech.
So every car needs a horn, and Alex wanted her car to have some defences against robbers. So we've taken a dog barking sound effect and we've loaded it onto this little audio effects board, which is similar to the board that we used when we made our farting stairs and our Daft Punk sneakers.
Make it. Do it. Makes sense.
And we've made our little emoji dog barking horn button. And when we press the horn, it triggers our barking sound effect. Tiggy is not impressed.
So we've wired up these switches, and these are going to control our lights and our reverse. So this is essentially our little dashboard. So excited about the switches.
So Alex's dog car is electric, so we need some way of powering our electric motor
built into our rear wheel.
So behind our seat down here, we've got this box, and inside this box, we're going to put some electronics and a whole load of these batteries. So these are lithium batteries, and they're going to be able to be charged up to store the electricity we need to power our motor.
So our motor has Bluetooth, so if we connect, it shows us our voltage, and then when we're driving, it will show us how fast we're going. How awesome is this? I feel this is what a Tesla feels like. Very Tesla. Elon Musk call us. So this is the speed controller for the wagging tail, so we can make it wag really fast or really slow. Let's see if it wags.
The car's wagging.
Oh, yay! Oh, I'm happy. So Alex wanted her dog car to have some security measures. So we put a camera in the front of this light and we'll be able to see what's going on this screen. So every car needs a number plate. It's a dog's nest. Oh, it looks so cute.
So we finished building Alex's dog car, and all that's left to do now is to test it. A massive thank you to Engineering Take a Closer Look for supporting this challenge. Check out their website for some awesome engineering inspiration and school resources.
We absolutely love Alex's invention idea, and we are super excited to be testing it out in our next video.
It's so fluffy!
See you next time.
Bye!
Don't forget to like and subscribe.